Hi students, today in this video we are going to see about 7th lab program of C programming laboratory. The title of the program is finding this prime number. So let us go to the question. Implement using functions to check whether the given number is prime and display appropriate messages. No built-in math function. This is my question. That means that we are going implement user defined function. That means this finding of prime number should be carried out with the help of functions and functions to check whether the number is prime or not, and no need to use the built-in function. Built-in mathematical functions are not available. For that we need to create a separate function which finds whether the number is prime or not. So this is my question. Now we will discuss about what is meant by prime number. We many of us know about the meaning of prime number. Prime number is nothing but if the number is divided by itself or by one, means that number is called as prime number. So if the number is divided by one or by itself, means that number is called as prime number. We need to find clarify about what is meant by prime number, because here one is obviously default number. Coming to 2 will be divided by 2 or by 1, and similarly 3 is also will be divided by 3 only, will be 1 only. But 4 is not a prime number because it can be divided by 2 also. So if the number is divided by itself and by 1, means that number is called as prime number. That is our task, to find whether the number is prime or not. How we are proposed to implement, means we are using the functions concept. So we are going to create one user defined function with our own name. In that, our task is to find whether the given input argument is prime or not. If the given argument is that number integer is prime, means we are displaying the number is prime or else no prime. So this is a very simple task. With this concept we are going to write a program. So first step is to inclusion of header files. So here stdio.h is a primary header file that has been included. And then after that, before going for the main concepts, we need to declare which function is going to implement for this concept. So I have named this function as isPrime. Okay, so isPrime is my name of the function. It takes one argument. It takes only one input argument and returns that input also. So in the returning type of my function is integer, and isPrime is my name of the function and it takes the argument as int. This is my function declaration that has been done. Then coming to void main. So void main, after the void main, we need to declare the variables which are required for these concepts. So here all are integer variables. Some temporary variables are there. So I need, that means how we are proposed to do this means, first I need to get the range of input elements. Say for example, from 10 to 20, I need to display the prime numbers. Or from 20 to 50, I need to display the prime number, means that is called as range. Okay, so that is called as range. So I need to get the range. How range? In the sense, the first range, first point value and last point. So here the first point value is stored in the variable called as a, and the last range, that means from 20 to 50, 50 is my last value. So that value 50 is stored is in variable b. So like that I have to get the range of input numbers to generate a prime number. So that is my logic. So like that I have declared the variables number, result, a, b, e, I, f equal to 0. Like that this variable declaration is done. Then coming to input reading. So what is the first input? I need to get the integers range. So this has been done with the help of scanf statement. Here ampersand a and ampersand b. So here a stores the lowest element and b stores the highest elements, right? So this should be that now we got no. So this should be displayed. So here from a to, that means from range, from the range of higher lowest element, from a to b, I need to get 11 elements. And that element should be checked with the help of isPrime function whether that number is prime or not. So for this concept, I need to implement for loop. So that's what for loop is written here. For I equal to A, that means I is started with the lowest element of A and I should be less than or equal to B, I plus plus plus. So my lowest element is A and highest element is B. So in this condition, I have started the for loop. For each I need to check whether the number is prime or not. So for that, I have written the function name called as isPrime. It will return prime numbers. So if that number will be returned. So if the number is prime, means it will return. So that is stored in the result. Okay. For the one condition, that means the number is 1, means that number will be a prime number, so that has been written. So this is my main concept. Coming to the isPrime function, how this prime function has been written here means we know the logic of finding the prime number. So it should take by a for loop. That means here for this I have declared one variable j. J equal to 2. J is less than or equal to n by 2. J plus plus. If modulo operator is the best operator to check whether the number is prime or not. So n modulo of j double equal to 0 means will not be a prime, because it may be divisible by something. Okay. So or else only it will be returned as a prime number. So return 1. So if the number is prime, I will return 1, or else I will return 0. So this condition is checked here. So isPrime is called here. Result equal to isPrime is called. If the result equal to 1 means, that means the number is given number. Input passed number is prime number. That will be printed 1 by 1. Or else it will not be printed. So it will go on execute the for loop once again. So in the second input element, isPrime is checked. If the number in the second element is prime, it will return the value as result equal to 1, or else it won't. It won't means it will return 0, or else in the same another case. So likewise it will be checked. If f equal to 0 means no prime numbers are exist in this case, so that is also shown here. So let us go to the program output. First case of output is enter the range of integer numbers to generate prime number. I have given 1 to 10 is my range. So from 1 to 10 I need to display the prime numbers. So we know that 1, 2, 3, 5, 7 are the prime numbers. Those are divisible by 1 and by itself. Then coming to second output, I have given the range from 20 to 50. So in this isPrime number function will be applicable from 20 to 50. So 20 to 50 means 10 to 50. Something wrong in that. It should start from 10 to 50. So here my output is starting from 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, 37, 41, 43, 47. Sorry, here the input range from 10 to 50. So here it should display the values from 10 to 50. So starting from 10, 11 is my prime number. 13 is my again another prime number. 17 is my prime number. 19, 23, 29, 31, 37, 41, 43, 47 is my prime numbers. So that has been displayed here. So I hope you understand this logic of this prime number implementation. I will catch you in the next video about next lab exercise.